Admiral Kuznetsov aircraft carrier is serving as the flagship of the Russian Navy. The ship was named after Admiral of the Fleet of the Soviet Union, Nikolay Gerasimovich Kuznetsov, who served in the Soviet Navy during the Second World War. This was launched in 1985, and commissioned in December 25, 1990. The ship has been deployed in many operations, and was recently involved in Syrian campaign. USS Carl Vinson is the third United States Navy Nimitz-class supercarrier and is named after Carl Vinson, a congressman from Georgia, in recognition of his contributions to the U.S. Navy. The ship was launched in 1980, and was commissioned on March 13, 1982. It has been deployed in Operation Desert Strike, Operation Iraqi Freedom, Operation Southern Watch, and Operation Enduring Freedom. Notably, the body of Osama bin Laden was buried at sea in 2011 from the deck of the Carl Vinson. In this video, Defense Updates compares the two aircraft's carriers based on five key aspects, and provides an unbiased conclusion. So, let us get started.
Number 5.
The Kuznetsov-class aircraft carrier was the last class of aircraft carrier designed for the Soviet Navy. She was built by the Black Sea Shipyard, the sole manufacturer of Soviet aircraft carriers, in Mykolaiv within the Ukrainian Soviet Socialist Republic. Two hulls were laid down in the Ukraine before the Soviet Union collapsed. Kuznetsov serves today in the Russian Navy, and other one is deployed by China, as Liaoning. Admiral Kuznetsov has gone for many refits and is expected to have a major upgrade soon. The Nimitz-class aircraft carriers were designed to be improvements on previous U.S. aircraft carriers, in particular the Enterprise and Forrestal class. Like all 10 Nimitz-class aircraft carriers, USS Carl Vinson was also constructed at Newport News Shipbuilding Company, Virginia, in the largest dry dock in the Western Hemisphere. Admiral Kuznetsov's size falls well below the USS Carl Vinson, the latter being over 60% heavier and 30 meters longer. USS Carl Vinson displaces about 100,000 tons and spans 333 meters long, far outsizing the Admiral Kuznetsov. The numbers bear out the fact that the Admiral Kuznetsov is neither a lightweight nor a supercarrier like Carl Vinson. Size has undeniable impact on the capability of any aircraft carrier as it determines the number of aircrafts that it can operate. Admiral Kuznetsov's air wing of 30 fighters falls well short of Carl Vinson's capability to hold over 65 jets. It can be easily inferred that USS Carl Vinson has a clear advantage over the Admiral Kuznetsov in this category.
Number 4.
Admiral Kuznetsov is powered by 6 diesel generators. The propulsion limits the Admiral Kuznetsov's range and endurance. Also, these are unreliable and even dangerous. It has seen many embarrassing malfunctions in recent years, and during Syrian campaign a tugboat accompanied Admiral Kuznetsov, in case the carrier broke down. USS Carl Vinson is powered by 2 A4W nuclear reactors, kept in separate compartments. These power 4 propeller shafts and can produce a maximum speed of over 30 knots or 56 kilometers per hour. As a result of the use of nuclear power, the ship is capable of operating continuously for over 20 years without refueling, and are predicted to have a service life of over 50 years. Clearly, USS Carl Vinson has huge advantage in terms of propulsion technology, and Admiral Kuznetsov is no match for it in this category.
Number 3.
Admiral Kuznetsov carry MiG-29K and Su-33 fighter planes. These are fourth-generation aircrafts and very capable jets. Currently, Russia doesn't have an operational stealth aircraft, and it will be some time before it inducts a stealthy carrier-borne aircraft. USS Carl Vinson strike fighters are primarily F-18 Hornets and F-18 Super Hornets. These are twin-engine carrier-capable fourth-generation multi-role fighter aircrafts. U.S. is also going to operate F-35C soon. The F-35C carries nearly 20,000 pounds of internal fuel for a longer range and better persistence than any other fighter in a combat configuration. There is not much difference between the aircrafts operated by these two carriers, all of them being fourth-generation aircrafts. The main consideration is that in near future, US will field F-35s, whereas it will take a much longer time before Russia can field a stealthy carrier-based aircraft, giving slight advantage to USS Carl Vinson.
Number 2.
Admiral KUZNETSOV uses ski ramp to assist aircraft takeoffs. USS Carl Vinson uses a more efficient steam-powered catapult system to launch aircraft. Ski jump aircraft carriers have limitations regarding how much ordnance can be loaded. The weight restriction issue is caused by a minimum airspeed requirement for flight from an aircraft carrier. Ski jump aircraft carriers generate their airspeed from the run-up distance on the deck of the aircraft carrier, and an assist from the ski jump. Catapult aircraft carriers use a steam piston system that accelerates a shuttle attached to the aircraft to produce a much higher end speed. Because the weight of the aircraft impacts the end speed, the higher the weight of the aircraft, the less end speed can be generated. For example, the Su-33 when launched from the Admiral KUZNETSOV can only carry 4,500 pounds of ordnance before it reaches its minimum airspeed requirement. Conversely, the F-18 Super Hornet can carry over 12,000 pounds of ordnance on a catapult aircraft carrier. The large difference in payload can certainly have impacts to tactical considerations for mission planning and sortie generation rates. Though carrier operators can bypass the inherent trade-off between carrying internal fuel and weapons on the aircraft, using mid-air refueling, the practice remains difficult to execute. Clearly, USS Carl Vinson has distinct advantage in this category.
Number 1.
Admiral KUZNETSOV is equipped with 3D air surface search radar over the main mast, and multiple other target tracking radars. Close-in weapon duties are performed by 6 AK-630AA guns and 8 Kashtan. 12 P-700 Granit anti-ship cruise missile is present, which has a range of around 625 km and speed of 1.5 Mach. 24-HCL-3K95 Kinzhal SAM VLS is responsible for air defense, and RBU-12000 rocket is responsible for anti-submarine warfare. Plans to upgrade the aircraft carrier call for obsolete Granit missile systems to be replaced with 3S-14 universal launch systems. Then the carrier can be outfitted with Caliber and K-class cruise missiles, Onyx supersonic anti-ship cruise missiles and the Zircon advanced hypersonic missiles, which reached speed of 8 Mach in recent test. Especially the Zircon missile integration will provide Admiral KUZNETSOV with excellent offensive capability. To know more about Zircon, check the above card. USS Carl Vinson possess multitude of different radars including electronically scanned array 3D radars. It is equipped with 16 to 24 RIM-7 Sea Sparrow or NATO Sea Sparrow missiles. RIM-7 Sea Sparrow is a U.S. shipborne short-range anti-aircraft and anti-missile weapon system, primarily intended for defense against anti-ship missiles. Its range is 19 kilometers. Close-in weapon, CIWS. Duties are performed by Phalanx, and IM-116 rolling airframe missile. Phalanx WZS has a 4,500 per minute rate of fire. RIM-116 rolling airframe missiles have speed in excess of 2 Mach. Admiral KUZNETSOV has no special protection, whereas USS Carl Vinson has 2.5-inch Kevlar over vinyl spaces. USS Carl Vinson has more mature equipment at present, but this will change drastically with upcoming upgrade of Admiral KUZNETSOV. Russia's aircraft carrier Admiral KUZNETSOV was excellent piece of engineering when it was built, but the ship has already done 3 decades of service and is on its last legs. Frequent breakdown bear the fact that it need major overhaul. As evident from the comparison, USS Carl Vinson is far ahead of Admiral Kuznetsov in terms of inbuilt technology as well as the overall ecosystem, but with planned upgrade, Admiral Kuznetsov will have most dreaded cruise missile Zircon in its armor, which levels the playing field to a great extent. In any conflict, the USS Carl Vinson will have more supporting vessels like submarines and AWACS, whereas Admiral Kuznetsov will have to depend on the asymmetric capabilities of the Zircon. The new Russian aircraft carrier Shturm will be included in Russia's next armament program for the 2019-2025 period. The nuclear power supercarrier will have displacement of 100,000 tons and will be able to carry 90 aircrafts. The aircraft carrier will go into service in the Navy by 2030, and will be one of the most potent platforms in the world. Ford-class supercarriers are being built by US to replace some of the United States Navy's existing Nimitz-class carriers. They are envisaged to be one of the most powerful carriers in the world and will start to be commissioned from next year. To know more, check the above card. As President Putin looked to modernize the Russian forces, the aircraft carrier battle is expected to heat up in coming days. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.